What at 16 years anniversary, the 16 year anniversary of Skanks for the Memories, what made you pick Denver to do the show?
Well, that's kind of sudden to ask me the first question with all these other comics up here, but well, that was like really a no brainer because I had played the club so many times and it was just such great crowds. And you know, back then when I was not an old man, I was pretty young. I was really in the game, you know, and I would say that, like, I really meshed up hardcore with the club and the crowd, and the staff's always so amazing. So it was really kind of like that was my first and only choice to do it there. And also, not to be all, whatever, there's something about the acoustics there, too, that, like, even, like, how many seats is the Comedy Works downtown?
Like 300.
Like... Yeah, whatever it is, but it's like, I guess because the sound through the rock or whatever is on the wall, it like bounces back at you and like you get that great immediate reaction. So I love that. And I think that is just part of why all the comics I know, all the comics who work the road always look forward to like playing the comedy. The other part would be the crowds. I think that, you know, it's a very cool crowd that can roll with a joke and they don't, you know, and this is years ago. They really did see the funny in everything, and they also let you like wing it and try it and like throw like half written stuff against the wall and like, you know, get the feedback right away. And I think Josh and these guys will agree with me is that like not every crowd will do that, you know, and that's why I picked that place to do my CD.
So, like, what are your as far you've probably played here what 5-6 times?
This club, the South Club.
But over. What, a decade probably here?
I don't know. It's been 10 years now. So I think, yeah, I think I was here early and I went through it. And I do, once again, you know, the crowds, my crowd has aged up a bit, but they're still out for a good time. And, you know, they drink hard, they laugh hard. And I always say they can take a joke. And I think tonight we had so many great comics on here, like just doing guest spots and dropping by. And that you could see that, like, they probably would stay another hour if they, you know... If there was more show, you know. Unfortunately, I don't have enough jokes, and I don't know how to work
so
a puppet.
That decade, have you seen, what would your analysis be of Denver comedy?
Oh, I think it's always been a strong scene. I think now it's a known scene. It was kind of like always like an undercover gem, and that now it's more metro. It's definitely a forward-thinking place, but I didn't see a lot of like, I'd say that the PC was at a low... It wasn't at like a super high bar. It was like people were out for a good time. So I would say that there's only a brighter tomorrow here, you know.
Yeah.
And if I could sing this song tomorrow, I would.
Well, yeah, I think I agree. And like we all look up to Josh as kind of the leader of Denver comedy.
Well, let's talk to Josh.
And
he's right here.
Well, they told me only to talk to you.
Well, that's kind of weird.
But
it's kind of like I'm the leader of 38 Special, and I like brought everybody these survivors.
But yeah, I'll definitely
Skinner
ask.
Door.
I'll ask Josh that because I know, as far as me and all the comics up here, we look up to you. You're considered kind of the king of Denver comedy.
Well, sure.
But how do you see the scene? You started?
The thing about this city is it's so supportive. Of all the comics. I feel like every person on here I've worked with and got a chance to like watch grow and like, well, except for you. Definitely.
I wish you could have met me when I was still alive.
I think we all like you better this way.
Well, okay, so then as like the youngest comic on the panel, Kyle, who's coming up,
he's the youngest guy?
Well, the
this 1%er biker looking guy?
Comedy years.
Okay.
But, and you're starting to go on the road. What have you seen as far as being out? Does it make you miss Denver? Or like for me, working these two clubs, it's kind of made me hate going on the road because they're so good.
Well, I'm just going on the road. This year was really the first year out on the road, so I'm just so starry-eyed about the whole experience. I love that. So that's it's tough to be objective, but I think it's the best of both worlds. I've been going through Texas and Louisiana.
I'm not laughing. No, I this guy, he's a national headliner. He can actually tell you.
But I think it's I get to do a lot of rooms that are less PC necessarily than coming back to Denver, and I have to tighten it up, and I have to do it differently in Denver than I do in Texas and Louisiana and Tennessee, and you know, so it's easier in one way on the road, and but it's better here, and I get better here every time I come back.
I think these clubs spoil you. I mean, that's it. If you're from here and you're doing shows and you're like, and you go on the road and you're like, fuck.
Well, we've heard from your side of the story. Yeah, I'd like my guys to give rebuttal opinions.
Well, yeah, Troy and Brent started here and now they're in LA. I would say the one thing I'd say about Comedy Works is how they grow their talent from the bottom up. So you guys had a chance to work with a lot of incredible comics. That's probably benefited you in LA, right?
Yeah. Maybe not. The thing about Los Angeles is nobody gives a shit who you are really when you first get there. It's like it's all about like working your way up. And I think that Comedy Works is like a good like starting place for that, in the sense that because you do have to like start at the bottom and they only give you a little more time. Earn it, and like all that kind of like farm system thing is good. And also working with all these like comics that are headliners, especially like the local headliners, when you have to like do shows, you have to follow Josh when you know Josh is like coming off of winning Last Comic Standing, and you're like, oh, I good, I get to follow him. Oh, and tomorrow I'm following Ben Roy, and then tomorrow like it's just like you get so used to having to just. Be in that it's good for your confidence to not be rattled when you're, because LA will be in shows where the whole lineup is stars. Yeah. And Comedy Works is like good for you. You're like, oh, okay, well, I'm just in the middle of this, fine, that's fine.
Right.
You know?
Well, I can say one thing is that there's no shortage of great comedy in this town. There is a bit of a shortage of sound engineering. As you can tell from the feedback on this mic. This is an East Coast thing, sorry.
As he walks back
into
the sun. Shit, okay.
Go ahead.
Well, I mean, I just went on the LA comic. I think that being here and being able, the way that she runs the club in terms of, it's not one comedian for the entire weekend opening up for someone. It's
yes.
All of us that get a chance to work with different comedians. That's very unique in my experience from what I've seen across the country. And when I am in Los Angeles, I do go to the clubs and I'm like, oh shit, look who's here. I work with, we know each other from the club because I've been here with them for so many years. And that's one of those big advantages that Comedy Works does that's a little bit different that I think has really set me forward in Los Angeles that most comics can't say that they have that experience.
Yeah. All right. Aaron, tell us something.
Hi, I'm Aaron. I talk now. No, I mean, it's such a great place to...
Thank you. That's your time.
Thank you very much. I'm Kyle Pogue. It's such a great place to start and to learn how to do comedy because, I mean, you get thrown into it with so many amazing comics. When I started, there were so many great people to look up to, like Josh and Ben Roy, all the Garlics guys, Andrew Orville, Adam Caden Hall. There's so many great...
Kevin.
Dr. Kev, of course.
Yes.
My father.
He's my dad, too.
He's all of our dads. He's our sweet, prolific comedy dad. And you get thrown into situations where, like Troy said, you have to follow. I think my first ever good set, I had to follow Ben Roy. And I was terrified.
Let's take a look at it. Oh, I thought it was a...
Go to the tape. My first set that I thought was good was following Ben Roy, and I just had to do it. I was terrified, but it worked.
Well, I know we want to wrap it up, so let's wrap it up with this. Everyone... Give your first Comedy Works memory or your favorite Comedy Works memory. And you can redo yours, Aaron, if you want, or Let's wrap this up, Dave.
What's wrong with my first one?
It was great. I'm just saying you can.
I mean, one of the ones that comes into my at this particular club, the South Club, was when I got to open up for Dan Gould, and I knew Dan Gould for sure, but I had never seen him live, and he just fucking floored me. He has this joke about the Black Dahlia murder.
Such a good.
That is so fucking good, and I'm not even gonna attempt to say it. And I just remember standing on that corner and just watching him work. I'm like, oh, okay, that's amazing. How you can, he's so confident in himself.
He's great.
And it was great to watch that. That was one of my first early memories for sure.
Yeah.
I opened for Dave Chappelle at the Downtown Club, and that was a really surreal comedy moment. It was, you know, just me and him on the show, and I was being paid to be there. Someone had asked me to come and do that, and I did, and it was amazing. And he was nice, and he told me I was funny, and it was nice of him to, you know, lie to me like that. It was incredible. And there's, I mean, you get to work with so many amazing guests. The club's the best. There's been a lot of moments like that.
Yeah, I mean, I think, like, a lot of us have gotten to work with, like, Chappelle and you, Dave, and, like, all these people who come in.
All the Daves.
Yeah, lots of Daves. So, like, I think, like, we all had a kind of, like, surreal experience like that. I think my first time I ever did New Talent Night, and I've been in, like, the open mics for, like, a while. Like, I didn't start signing up for, like, a long time. So I already had, like, a dive bar tested set. And I remember, like, looking out at the crowd and being like, you're wrong. This is not this good. this is not, no. I know what this is, and it's not this. And then I also think that comedy works, other than like a lot of scenes, one of the things that used to be, and still is, so much fun about it is the sort of camaraderie and the like, the way we like mess with each other, and the way there's like a hostility, a friendly hostility in our scene that I really like. One of the first times I ever headlined, speaking of, Ben Roy was in front of me, and he did all of his strongest stuff, and then he got off stage and said, "That's for every time you did that to me." And he killed me in front of my friends.
Kyle, go ahead. Kyle, go.
Tomorrow, I'm going to do my first ever set on a weekend show, and I'm downtown, and I'm doing it because Kyle Kinane asked me to. That's my favorite moment, one of my favorite moments in life. And honest to God, I've wanted to see you forever, and I get to walk in here and stand in the back for free because I'm a Denver comic, and it blows my mind. I'm hyper grateful for everything all the time.
To watch me or Dave?
You. But I like Dave's stuff too.
Thank you, buddy.
Go ahead, Dr. Gubb.
Well, I'm curious on this one.
Uh-oh. Well, there's, you know, decades, man. Yeah. And so I started with Noah. You know, and Moses, but it's such a supportive scene, you know, here, you know, the club downtown, it's a low ceiling, and so the laughs hit that ceiling, and so it stays right in there, and so it's just, I think the best thing for me is how supportive the comics here are of each other, you know, and supportive in a way, too, that they'll tell you, hey, that doesn't work, or whatever. I started as a chicken act, you know, with Chick Fowler and Jackie Davis. And I was Chick Fowler, and the chicken was Jackie Davis. And so that didn't work.
Slow it down. Everyone's Googling. A chicken act.
There used to be a lot of them. I'd say my favorite thing are my friends in the business. The danger in this business is you forget about your civilian friends, and you'd rather hang around with your buddies from the business. And that there's a danger in that. So... I mean,
it's Josh doing.
All right.
That's a very cool one to put it.
Is it my turn?
It's your turn.
Oh, okay. This is my home club, so I have a billion different amazing moments that formed the comic that I am. But one of my favorites is I came to this club when Tom Green was headlining. I grew up watching, you know, Tom Green, and I got to smoke weed with him. I smoked him some weed, and then it's about like 4 minutes before he's supposed to go on, and the club is panicked. They can't find him, and I got him so high that he was like had his head on that wall, sitting in the audience, and they like woke him up like, man, you're on. Fuck yeah. And I did the same thing to Norm MacDonald.
Yeah, I was there for that.
Go ahead, Dave. You wrap this up for us.
Well, there's just some interesting, not too short memories. I would like to say, and this actually comes from the heart, and it really does come from the heart, is that like you can always tell a great crowd by the staff, and both downtown and here. These people, it's not just a job, they're passionate about comedy. You can tell that they love when the comic rocks the room. They know comedy. No one ever knows comedy better than someone who works at a comedy club. So as a comic, when someone in who works on the staff goes, hey man, that was a great set, I take that as an extra win for me because they see hundreds of headliners during the year, you know? And I will say that from Wendy on down to both the comics and the staff is that you guys, you know, you can just tell that this is definitely like a special scene and there's very few towns like that. I'll name a few if you want. DC, San Francisco, you know, these are some places where you can tell both the staff and the comics, you know, they're all in it together. And I always felt this way about this club and a lot of the comics do. So that's why it's always a special high coming back here for that. So that's what I have to say. That's my memory, which is a, you know,
which
actually a shout out to the club.
Well, I'll just say this. I know the whole Old South Club was so excited you were coming, the downtown club, which
yes.
I told you immediately was like, please come back downtown.
I wanted
me
to
and Aaron
it.
Both, I'm sure, I know I did, I think Aaron did too, asked Wendy if we could have this. The fact all these guys came and hung out to see you.
Well,
is
I don't know how they're going to afford us because this seven-man team thing that we're doing.
They can afford
turn
six
the cameras
of, well, they
around.
Can afford five
it is
of us.
A sellout.
Wendy can afford five of us. She knows that. But thank you, Dave.
Thanks
for doing
guys.
This. We good, Eddie? Thank you so much, buddy.
Thank
you, guys.